Are you ready to listen to a podcast?
Here comes the Playhouse Podcast, thanks to Bradshaw and Brian Law Offices.
Find, subscribe, and listen.
Kim, we're going to call you Kim, and Psychic Kim, we're going to call you Psychic Kim, okay? Does that make sense, guys?
Sounds good, yeah.
All right, Kim, what's your question for Psychic Kim?
Yeah, good morning, Kim. My question is, I just accepted a new job. It's a lateral position, so I'm just checking to see, was this a good move, and hopefully a good future move for the corporate world.
All right, Psychic Kim, what do you think for Kim?
I definitely see the lateral move. I see that. I don't see a ladder where you're moving up. I see it like, yes, going over. I don't feel this strong, like, oh my gosh, yes, woohoo, this is amazing. I am definitely not feeling that, but I'm not feeling the doom and gloom. So it's more so it's going to work for a little while, but you're going to get bored. You're going to want a little bit more challenge. You're going to be wanting more stimulation, however that means to you. So
sounds
I
like every girl I've ever dated. When I,
right, exactly. Maybe more.
Thanks.
I'm just kidding. Jesus. So I see binoculars going out, and that means you're going to be start looking. I don't know if that's looking outside the company, but it could be looking more internal too. Yep, more internal as to what else you can do. So, but it's not a bad move.
Not bad, but not Michael Jordan status.
Yep.
Okay.
Agreed. Okay.
All right. Thanks.
Perfect.
Thanks,
Thank you
Kim,
so
number
much.
One. You're welcome. Have a great morning. You know what? I was intrigued by Carrie as we chatted before we got her on the air here. Carrie, how long ago did you get proposed to?
Well, we have been together for going on 7 years, and we have been engaged for 2.
Okay.
That's a lot of milk that you've been giving away.
That's okay. That's, no, you don't have to push it right away. But you,
it's a give and take. He's taken a lot of my crap, and so...
Okay. You've given him a lot of crap. Okay, so your question, Carrie, then is?
My question is, do we see a wedding in the future, or like is our relationship, you know, do we have a future, or is there, you know, something that's going to come up?
Psychic Kim?
Yes.
I'm getting pulled to the end of 2023 and then 2024. So it's potentially a date could be set closer to the end of 2023. But your spirit guides are showing me more definitely the 2024. There's a lot of things that are going to influence this date, though.
Mm-hmm.
Either there's things coming up in life, either there's finances, whatever. But there's a lot of things that I feel like are roadblocks. And it's not that you guys need to get married. So you guys are good with each other. It's more so like, oh, okay, there's the formality. We'll go through with it. But you're good.
You're going to get pretty, girl. I bet you.
I just had a baby. I don't want no more. I got 4. I'm good.
Whoa. Yeah, you're
all right.
Done.
Yeah. All right. Well,
by my luck, I'll be pregnant by next year.
Well, you know, there are things you can do to prevent that, right?
Yes. Many.
Oh, I've gotten pregnant every birth control you can think of.
Sounds like a lawsuit. I don't know if that's true.
This is for another show. Thank you, Carrie, and best of luck. So how are you?
I'm good.
Hey, I appreciate you holding. You got Psychic Kim. What's your question this morning?
So I've been single for a while now and casually like dating and going on dating sites and whatnot. And I'm just wondering if there's like love or a relationship in my near future.
What would you consider near future, by the way, Tanisha?
like within the next maybe 6 months.
All right. Are we going to get a boyfriend or something before you know, Valentine's Day is what you're hoping for?
Right.
What do you think, Kim?
So you're kind of picky. I'm going to throw that out there. You have a little bit of a good sense of what you want and what you don't want. I don't want to use the word control, but I'm kind of leaning more towards a little controlling issue within yourself, which is actually they're showing me thumbs up. That's a really good thing because you're going to start seeing those people that don't jive with you. I'm getting more pulled towards like 2023, like August, September, so possibly another year before you actually find they're showing me a ring on the finger, that true person. So it's going to be a little bit yet, but they're like, you can still have fun. You can still enjoy life. But that person that's going to come into your life and very deep eyes, deep, like I'm getting pulled to really deep brown eyes, by the way, just sucked right in. So, and something about the eyebrows too. Oh my gosh, like deep set eyes and these big old eyebrows.
He sounds like a great catch, Phoenicia.
He sounds hot.
Remember, when you lower your standards, you end up with guys like me, and it could work.
He has one eyebrow.
Right.
Four fingers.
All right, well,
wouldn't that be great if you could just narrow it down to exactly what he looks like?
And then you could just go on the four-finger dating website.
Yeah, why not?
Right, and just be like, hey, the psychic up at the Playhouse said, you're my match. We got to make this happen. Otherwise, it's meant to be. So,
good luck to you.
All right. Well, have fun searching for that guy with the weird eyebrows and sunken in eyes. All right. Have a great day, Tanisha.
You sounds like a Halloween costume.
Right, good. But that is so specific. All right. We have time for one more before our big giveaway. Val, how are you today?
Hi, good.
Good. You have Psychic Kim. Your question is?
It's about my brother that passed away.
Okay.
In May. And I'm just wondering if he's at peace now and if he's suffered much.
Oh, I'm so sorry for your loss.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you.
So normally it takes me a little bit longer to tune into people who are on the other side. So my first initial feelings was this, like I wanted to kind of joke around and be, and like put my arm down and be like, no, I'm not at peace. But then I want to laugh inside. Almost like he's trying to joke around. That's like my initial feeling with this. And I keep hearing laughter in my head. Like, I just want to laugh and I just want to be, oh, I just want to cry. Mm. This is your feeling though, not his. Whew. That's really heavy. I can feel your grief just coming through more than I can feel him right now. Wow. But on the other hand, I want to laugh and just run around and joke around and be a little bit more sarcastic, witty, whatever that vibration is coming off of him. That's what I'm feeling. So normally if I'm feeling that, that's a good thing. That's they kind of let go of the earthbound junk, I want to call it, all of our sorrows, our worries, when they're joking around, when they're having a good time on that level. Yes. He shows me coins. Look for coins. I keep flipping a coin in my finger and I want to like drop it like here and there. Like to keep flipping a coin. So I don't know if he ever did that with his fingers or what, but I want to flip a coin on the ground, by the way. So that's going to be his thing to you to say that he is okay, because he's like, you need something tangible to know that I am okay. So look for the coins.
Okay.
Does that help, Val?
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Good, you're welcome.
You know, that's something for people to hang on to, too. I have a friend that lost her sister, and, like, her sister was so into birds and one specific kind of bird, and then whenever that bird would show up or be in presence, it was just something nice to think about, you know? It was like, oh,
yep,
thinking about your sister in a good way and not her suffering from cancer when she did, you know?
It's time for the Halloween match game. Joel, how you feeling this morning?
I'm feeling swell. How are you?
Good. Are you? Would you venture to say you're leaning towards Cerebral or a little bit more towards Cat?
Oh, Cerebral.
Yeah,
sure.
I think so.
Wow, Joel, thanks. And it's not a trivia game. This is like just like basically mind reading. Also, want to thank you. Did you see my Facebook post to you? Thank you for the big log.
You're very welcome.
Oh, my God. I'm so excited. We're going to light it during Halloween.
Makes me happy when my big log excites me.
All right. All right. We're good here now, Joel. All right. So it is time for Halloween match game. Here's how this works. Kat has already given us her answers. If you can come close at all to any of these answers, then I will shower you with goody goodness out of the Playhouse prize closet. Are you ready to rock?
Yes, sir.
You just got to try and predict what Kat filled in the blank with. Joel, when Silly Sally is blank every night is Halloween. When Silly Sally is blank.
And remember to keep it kind of clean.
Every night is Halloween. What do you think Kat said there?
Drunk.
What did I say?
She said angry.
Angry. I'm silly Sally angry.
Okay.
See, I didn't really like the assignment at all because I wanted to say so much more than that. You know, and I just had to narrow it down to one word.
Number two, Joel. Shameless Shane thinks Halloween is the best holiday because it's all about blank rather than family and responsibility. Shameless Shane thinks that Halloween is the best holiday because it's all about blank rather than family and responsibility.
All about tricking.
No, that's a great answer.
What'd I say?
Hunting.
See, I filled this out and I totally forgot.
Oh, you said, actually, you said haunting. Sorry. Haunting. Haunting, yes. Not hunting.
Okay.
Can't read your writing.
All right.
All right. I think we're going to dial in on this one, Joel. I think it'll be okay. Kinky Catherine turned heads when she put an ad in the paper offering to trade blank for candy.
I remember what I was on.
Kinky Catherine turned heads when she put an ad in the paper offering to trade blank for candy, Joel. What do you think Kat said?
Remember, kids are in their car.
I'm going to say tricks.
My tricks.
I'm going to take that. Yes, yes.
All right.
Kat used another off-brand term for her lady part. And
rhymes with moon.
All right, all right, all right. We're good. All right. the third one.
Do you ever call it that?
Fourth one. No, stop. We can't have this conversation
right
now.
All right, go ahead.
Number four. Nothing scares Halloween Harry because Harry is a blank. Joel, nothing scares Halloween Harry because Harry is a blank.
A beast.
Close.
Did I say a ghost?
She said a ghost.
All right.
Nothing scares a ghost. All right, Joel, we move on to Miss Mary. Miss Mary is still a kid at heart. Every Halloween, she goes out looking for front porches that are blank. So Miss Mary, she's still a kid at heart. And every Halloween, she goes looking for front porches that are blank.
You won't get mine.
Scary.
No, Kat used the popular answer, filled with rotten pumpkins so she can throw them on the driveway.
Don't do that.
That's
not
a lengthy
nice
answer.
Yeah, all right. Last one, because
there's another one?
Yeah, there's one more. Yeah.
All right.
Joel, sinful Samuel said, hell is mostly empty, but all the blank are there. Sinful Samuel said, hell is mostly empty, Joel, but all the blank are there.
Fun people.
Fun people are in
no,
hell?
No, Kat said Catholics.
I did
not.
No.
She said loud chewers.
Yeah.
I mean, is there a better place for a loud chewer
Amos
than the deepest depths of Satan's realm?
Yeah.
Well, I gotta say, I'm probably correct.
Get up and go to work, just like everybody else. Nobody won the Powerball jackpot, but that means $800 million plus waits for you on Saturday, which is huge. That is the second biggest ever. And California, though, Connecticut, Illinois, Michigan, New York, they all had million-dollar winners. So
that's all right.
That's all right.
You can have your million. I'll take my $800.
There you go. Police are identifying a woman killed in the parking lot of her workplace on Monday morning. The victim is 28-year-old Nicole Michelle Hammond of St. Cloud. A criminal complaint against the suspect, 36-year-old Michael Carpenter, says that he shot her in the neck and she died at the scene, reportedly upset over her rejecting his advances. He has now been charged with second-degree murder. This is a great conversation to have with the men and the boys in your family, that rejection happens. Rejection is a part of life.
Here's
how you deal with it is the next move.
Here's what I'd like to know, how this isn't first degree. He had to load a gun and go to her workplace, right?
Upset.
So that would be premeditated, wouldn't
right
it? Right. Unless they think they've got a better chance at making second degree stick. And I know it's early and stuff, but I'm obviously not a lawyer, but I don't understand how driving to someone's workplace isn't premeditated.
I know. Like, do you go in your head, do you go to Reagan and somebody wanting to date her and she just says no? It is her prerogative. It's her right.
Yeah.
And this happens. It's tragic. And I pray for the whole family.
Well, I mean, think about every woman now that's hearing this that goes, I don't want to date this slime ball.
Yeah.
And you have to worry and look behind you to think that he might come shoot
not
you at
right
your job. I mean, that's just horrible.
All right. So this was, I don't know if you saw this video in Pasadena, California. Police arrested a woman. She was caught on video. She had a pickaxe. and she walks up to this house. Did you watch it?
I did.
She looked beautiful. She looked like it looked like a horror film. She's 65 years old, beautiful, long green dress on, black top, and she just takes a pickaxe to this guy's windows.
The glass shards from these giant windows were literally double her size, right in her bassinet where my daughter was laying. If she was 5 seconds late, my daughter would no longer be with us.
That's the grandma.
Help! Questions, anyone?
Oh.
I'll be back. Get out.
Whoa. It looked like The Purge, where they calmly walk away with the pickaxe over their shoulder. So she's now taken into custody. She's charged with damage to property, $20,000 worth. But she smashes one window, leaves. That gives the grandma enough time to grab the baby that was sitting at the second window. And the baby would have been smashed by glass. It was just horrific.
Obviously, some mental health situations going on here.
We're going to switch gears and end on a lighter note. I loved this picture because I have a story that goes along with it. This coal miner is making headlines because he goes and he's just all dirty. He was working in the coal mine all day, and his kid really wanted to go to a University of Kentucky basketball game. And so he rushes after work, grabs the kid, goes to the game.
I've done some things that have been fulfilling for my wife and I, but this, you're bringing light to a good man, a hard-working Kentuckian, a coal miner who does everything he can to make time for his family and his son and his daughter. Come on, that's what it ends up being. That's the story.
So they got courtside season tickets now.
Kentucky's head basketball coach, his father was a coal miner. And so this kind of hit him in the spot and saying, oh my gosh, I know how much of a sacrifice my dad made.
Yeah.
And I see this guy making a sacrifice for his kids. Let's get him some VIP tickets.
I remember Liam was pretty young and he was in youth, like micro sports. And he said, so-and-so's dad is always so dirty. Look at his clothes. And I go, does he have a job? He goes, yeah. And I go, that means he makes money for his family. And he works construction, doing a job that most of us are not made to do.
I've seen that so many times over the course of the years coaching kids that, you know, dad will show up in the second inning, like straight in his work clothes and just there to be with their kid. And I can't respect anything more.
Yep.
64% of couples share their passwords for this. What is it? Not Netflix, not email.
Cell phone.
Cell phone
that
is right.
My guess.
That is it.
Yes.
Yeah. Well done, man. So, yeah. Kat, what do you have? Josh, do you have an iPhone or are you an Android like Kat? And then be
I have an iPhone. Oh, okay. No, never.
No.
I don't even have a password on my phone. I just don't care.
Do you have someone in your life that you're coupled with?
First time in like 5 years. Yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah. Now, do you share passwords?
I'm excited. Yeah.
Okay, so do they have your password then, right, for your phone? Because I'm sure you have it set up for face recognition.
Yeah.
But they could pop in there anytime they want.
He's got it.
Does Derek have yours?
I don't have a password.
Yeah.
We don't have passwords. The only time I regret not having a password is when I left it in the bathroom at Target.
Oh.
And I was like, all you think about is what did I text the last like 5-6 people?
Right.
Do I have nudes? What videos did I look up? Whoa. What's in my Google search engine? That is what goes through my head. And then I'm like, I got to get a
password.
Josh,
the filth that she has on her work computer, if any of that is on her phone.
You make me Google the answers.
I'll make
to
you Google
questions.
Anything. My wife and I have the same, like, you know, if you have an iPhone, you got the face recognition, but then sometimes it doesn't recognize you because you have a hat on or whatever, or sunglasses. And my wife and our passwords for our phones are the same thing.
I got
4 digits. So yeah. Hey, anyways, you're a little bit closer to $100. Congratulations.
Hey.
What are you up to this morning?
I'm on my way to work.
All right,
so why did it take you 5 years to couple up again?
My dude's picky.
You know, that I'm picky, and you know, I might have had to, you know, have gotten over a 18-year marriage.
Oh, got it. Geez. Okay.
So you think that's a popular ratio? If you're married 18, you want to take 5 off, or if you would have found this lady, would have you been quicker to get to the wheel?
Well, the funny thing is I did find her like 3 years ago, but you know, it took us a while.
But you screwed it up. because guys are dumb.
She screwed it up.
I like this guy. Right. You ever think about that? You've been married a long time.
Do I ever think about what?
Like if it ended, like you and Derek said, all right, this doesn't work for us anymore. How long before you actually got back into like a serious relationship?
Literally had this conversation yesterday with Allie. Because I don't know. Forget it. I can't even tell you why we got into this conversation, but I just said, no, I can't ever see myself dating anybody ever again. Just sounds horrible.
I'm kind of good with me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It would have to be really organic. Like, is it somebody I've been friends with for a long time? Right. And then we're just like, wow, we really connect on that level. Let's never do it and eat all the time. Like, that just sounds like a dream.
Today, the question I've got on our Facebook page is, what are you asking Santa for this year? Let's say he's only watching our Facebook page today. He's a huge fan of the Playhouse. But what are you asking Santa for? Sheila's first answer, a new or new to me hybrid SUV to help with the winter and get better gas mileage. Yes, I'm a very Minnesotan person. Nice. What would you ask Santa for right now today?
I want one of those. I don't know if you'd consider it an ATV, but it's got the one tire in the front and the two in the back.
Oh, like a, Are they a Can-Am
spider?
Spider, I think, yeah.
I need one.
I've always wanted one.
They're like in my neighborhood, four people have them and they are so fly.
Really?
I would love to pick Liam up in that every day on like hot days. He would love that.
Maybe.
And you don't even have to wear a helmet with these.
Oh, yeah. That's real safe.
Yeah.
I think that's what you want, right?
I belong in one. Oh, these are the ones with the two.
Two in the front, one in the back.
Yeah.
That what it is? Yeah. Shut up. All right, so this guy was on, this is Dr. Phil.
Yes, listen.
I mean, I don't talk to my family.
What?
They're irrelevant.
They're irrelevant?
None of them have followers. If they got followers or got rich, I'd probably talk to them again.
Hang on a minute. Did you just say I don't talk to my family because they don't have followers?
If they had followers, they'd be here right now.
You talk about your mother?
I mean, my mom has more followers than my sister.
It's your mother. What difference does she make? What do you care if she has followers or not? It's your mother.
Can anyone tell me like what I would talk to my mom about if she's not going to be making me relevant?
What? I just like.
That's why tigers eat their young.
I cannot run into somebody like that. It would not be good with my mouth. I would just be.
I don't know if I'd have time to waste on a human like this if I was talking to him. I think I'd be outie pretty quick.
Is there anyone in your family that, because he's obviously embarrassed of his family, that they don't have TikTok followers or Facebook followers or a large mass
amount of people to influence?
Yeah. So who, let's say who in your family, and you can go extended.
I'm looking probably in the mirror at this one.
You are?
Yeah, I'm pretty much the outcast of our family.
Well, I was going to say the same thing. My sister is in the dental world. And kind of killing it in the weed world.
Yeah, no, it's great.
Legally for a massive company. And then my brother.
She's got chickens.
My brother, yes.
Yeah, she's urban farming.
He works for the city of Maple Grove and basically does everything. And then my brother, my other brother is a teacher. And then I gave away truck nuts the other day. Like sometimes
I told a boob joke.
They do a lot of like air quotes when they're around me. They're like, "How's your job?" And they'll like throw up stuff like that. So I can only imagine that maybe I am the one that is embarrassing them. Do you have someone in your family that is embarrassing? Maybe you have that relative. Maybe your sister posts everything on Facebook for the world to know. Maybe your brother tans nude in his front yard. I don't know.
There's a guy, his name is Mark. He's on line three. And he said,
already.
He said, oh, so if I'm getting this right, basically all of his brothers he's embarrassed about. Gotta hear this guy that was on Dr. Phil. Just one more time for content.
I mean, I don't talk to my family.
Why not?
They're irrelevant.
They're irrelevant.
None of them have followers. If they got followers or got rich, I'd probably talk to them again.
Hang on a minute. Did you just say I don't talk to my family because they don't have followers?
If they had followers, they'd be here right now.
Oh, my God.
You talk about your mother?
I mean, my mom has more followers than my sister.
It's your mother. What difference does she make? What do you care if she has followers or not? It's your mother.
Can anyone tell me like what I would talk to my mom about if she's not going to be making me relevant?
I don't don't know. Maybe she should show you her scars from where
she
gave
you
birth.
Period.
Yeah. So the question is going to be, what are you embarrassed of when it comes to a family member?
This guy's embarrassed that his family member doesn't. They don't have tons of followers.
I know. He wants them to have millions and millions of people following them on TikTok. Sarah texted, I'm embarrassed of my younger sister. She keeps having kids and then giving them to family members. She doesn't have custody of any of them. She has six. She's only 32. That's a crisis. That is really bad.
Mark, I appreciate you holding. I know you want to talk about your brothers. Can you fill us in a little bit here?
You know, throughout growing up, like, I was always told that I was like the most handsome of my siblings.
Okay, not a problem.
Looking back, like, it was true, but like looking around now.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, like, I mean, I've always taken pride in, like, how I look. I've always, like, made sure I was, like, dressed properly, like, my clothes were clean and neat.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, like, my fingernails were clean. Sadly, I can't say the same thing about my brothers, and I just wish they would, like, step up at this point. We're all adults.
When it comes to being embarrassed, like, the level of embarrassment, will you go out in public with them?
I'll meet them places. If that's what you mean, but like, I don't want to, like, I wouldn't walk in with them. Like,
wow.
I look like I'm like,
these are your own brothers?
Oh my God. And they have jobs. They're not bums.
They have jobs, but they look like bums.
Wow.
Wow. I'm going to need, like, you're going to have to text me a picture of yourself.
Well, sure. But like, I'll send you a picture of me and just one of them in sweatpants at Thanksgiving.
All right.
What's trending? What's trending?
We thought life always had to be so tough around Halloween. That is until we met 73-year-old TikToker Barbara Babs Costello.
Don't stand and carve your pumpkin. Sit. Just put them on your lap. Now time to cut the bottom of your pumpkin, not the top. Use your hand mixer. And I'm going to remove all those nasty strings the easier way. It literally cuts the job in half. When designing your pumpkin face, use a dry erasable red marker that you can get rid of the lines after you carve. If you don't want to struggle using a knife to carve your pumpkin, just use a soft-headed mallet and your cookie cutter.
Why do we cut at the top? And then you risk burning your hand when you light that candle. Why wouldn't you cut the bottom? She's brilliant.
Yeah.
And then she used a handheld mixer to get rid of all the orange hairs and pumpkin seeds.
What
in
got
a
me
matter
was
of
the,
seconds.
The mallet and the cookie cutters. You just pound those in. Now you got perfect star eyes or moon eyes or whatever you want to use.
What did we do before Babs?
Thanks, Babs.
That's crazy. I know the other day you were looking online for the Ford Fiesta.
I was going to look at getting a new one, yeah.
Yeah, don't, because they are discontinuing. After 47 years, they're being replaced by electric vehicles.
How many of our listeners do you think were conceived in a Ford Fiesta?
We say adios to the Fiesta, I know. Text in if you were. That'd be interesting to
find
out.
And tell us about how limber your parents are, because that was a little car,
that's
right?
That's a cramped quarter, yes, for sure. Okay, so it's been a weird week for Taylor. This is her new song, Antihero.
It must be exhausting, always rooting for.
All right, so she had to change up her music video for this because she uses the word fat.
Well, so when she gets on the scale,
it says,
you know,
fat.
It says fat, and people lost their minds, man.
Yeah, so it's a scene where, you know, it just tells the truth. It is the reality of girls her age, younger women my age. You get on there, and you're so mean to yourself. And so I don't think she should have done that. It was nothing to attack a religion, a race. It is factual.
She
and
got
so
shamed pretty heavy on that.
Yeah, I'm sad that she did that. I think she's going to kick herself down the line because it had a good message. It's like, listen, just be happy with you. And that is the four before you hit the door. Just kidding. That was trending.
You're up in the Playhouse with Kat and JJ.
I have chicken salad in front of me.
Guys, you she's been telling me about how awesome this chicken salad from Costco is for the last hour.
It is.
She'll take a bite.
So good.
And it'll be like dead quiet in here. And she'll go, this chicken salad from Costco is amazing. And I'm like, you got me sold. I'll get some the next time I
you
go.
You should. But it's so good. It's so healthy for you. It's rotisserie chicken. You love rotisserie chicken.
Who doesn't love rotisserie chicken? Then what, you got some Pringles there or something?
Pringles?
Doritos?
No, these are pita chips.
Pita chips with
Listen,
your chicken salad?
I've been so freaking, like, even more healthy than I normally am lately. I'm doing it for me. Doing it for this body.
The Playhouse Podcast is made possible thanks to Bradshaw and Brian Law Offices. Catch the live show weekdays from 5:30 to 9 on 104.7 KCLD. Now, share this with a friend.